I hope you guys are having a wonderful week. This week has been full of celebrations for us. We had our third year anniversary, my birthday, and Labor Day. That calls for celebration too, right? A whole day off. Anyways, I wanted to share with you guys our floral arrangements and bouquet tutorial that we did at our wedding. It was such a DIY wedding where all of our friends and family came together to make it such a magical event. For our reception, we had super long tables and it was kind of a farm style, so I had to come up with a unique way to make it look pretty. And this was our place setting. I had almost like 50 of these vases and other small little vases with the same kind of look, just kind of spread out. So let's get right on into how I did the centerpiece. First, I grab this beautiful pink rose, measure it against the vase, and then I'm gonna cut it. Snip off the excess, and I'm gonna strip the leaves. You want just a bare stem. I'll put it in the vase, and now I'm moving on to the freesia. Doing the same thing. I want this one a little bit taller, just create a little bit of height. And now some white stalk to fill. I'll cut off the end, and then again remove the leaves. Hi, Ollie. Then I'll add it to my vase and see how that looks. Jostle everything around to make sure it looks good. Then I'll add a table number.
In each of the vases here, I also stuck in the table number to guide the guests on where they sat. My sister also DIY'd this. She used her silhouette machine and some hard glitter paper that you can just find at Michael's. She cut the numbers and then I just glued it onto these wooden sticks that I found at Michael's as well.
And then for a final rustic touch, I'm just gonna add some foliage that I grabbed from the garden. Any kind of foliage will do. And that's my centerpiece.
My friend Brianne, who worked with me at Sunset Magazine, and her sister Robin came up the Friday before our wedding and they just spent the whole day helping me assemble all of these floral arrangements. It came out so beautiful. My friend Lauren, who was a garden editor, she had planted and grew a bunch of dahlias and zinnias and all these beautiful flowers for her wedding a month before, so she let me use a lot of the leftover dahlias that was still in the garden, so we had freshly cut flowers that we also used in the arrangements. So thank you guys for letting me share with your flowers. Our wedding was such a beautiful day. We got married in Menlo Park at Sunset Magazine where I work, and only employees are able to have events and weddings there, so I felt really special. And also, I was the last wedding before that whole campus got sold. It was 7 acres of garden and land, and it was so beautiful. We got married under the redwoods, and we had the reception underneath the big oak tree that's like over 100 years old. If you guys want to see photos from my wedding and how everything came together, I will post a blog post on my website at honeysucklecatering.com. Now for my next DIY tutorial, I'm gonna show you guys how to make a bridal bouquet. This could also be your bridesmaid's bouquet as well. And for the bouquets and flowers, actually, I worked so close with Lauren to figure out the kind of color palette and flowers that I wanted. I used David Austin roses, lisianthus, dahlias, since they're so beautiful, and let's see, what else? We just kind of used all the seasonal flowers that was available. I really wanted peonies for my bridal bouquet, but it was really expensive since they're out of season. It was like $60 a stem plus shipping, and I had to get it from Alaska, so I didn't really think that was practical, so we went with the David Austin roses. So here's how you would assemble the bridal bouquet.
I'll start with some roses. Again, strip the leaves off. Perfect. Then I'm just gonna take three roses. I want to start with three rose stems, and this will be the dome or the center of our bouquet. Bunch them together, and I'm just gonna cross the stems to make like a loose bouquet. Then to add some dimension, I'm just gonna take a freesia, some seeded eucalyptus, and I'll place them in between the roses. Now taking my spray roses, I'm gonna add more flowers to the bouquet.
I actually really love the way that spray roses look because they're still very elegant, yet they're super cheap.
Kind of work in a circular pattern and make sure it creates a nice kind of domey circle. It's okay to have some height with the stalk and the freesia, but with the roses, since they're the main flowers, just make sure you kind of reshape them as you go.
The foliage, stalk, and freesia will give it that rustic look, that loose bouquet that's really on trend right now. More fillers, and let's say if the spray roses or the rose kind of slip down and looks a little shorter, just futz around with it and pull it up. Now to measure where to trim the stems, I need to make sure that I can fit 2 fist lengths, and I'll give it an extra 2 inches at the bottom, and that's where I'm gonna trim it. Chop, chop, chop. Garden shears are best for this. Now I'll bunch it together with a rubber band to hold everything in place. This will help guide my floral wire, which I will get into next. I'll stick the end of the floral wire into the bundle, and then I'll just start wrapping it around tightly. This is to make sure our bouquet doesn't come apart. Once it's fully wrapped around, I'll trim the wire, and again, I'll just loop it around and tuck it into one of the stems. Perfect. A nice and tight bouquet. But wait, we're not done yet. To make it pretty, I have a ribbon here that I'm just gonna wrap around to cover the floral wire and to make it look bridal. Wrap it all the way down.
And just for a really nice final touch, for the ribbon, we secured it with these pearl pins right here that mimic the back of my dress. It was such a beautiful detail that just kind of tied everything together.
Isn't this gorgeous? Everything is nice and secure. I chose a pink, gold, and white color palette because that's what I use for my wedding.
You guys, so for all the flowers that I used today, it was actually very cost efficient. I only spent $40. I went to Trader Joe's and Whole Foods and just got a bunch of stock roses and spray roses. Spray roses was actually one of the best filler flowers that I could find. They're super cheap and they really look elegant too. Another filler flower that I love is stock and lisianthus. I wasn't able to find any lisianthus today down here, but I did get a lot of stock. For my wedding, the total cost of flowers I spent was $500. I went to the SF Flower Mart early on Thursday morning before our wedding to pick out all the flowers that we wanted. $500 sounds like a lot, but it's actually really, really cheap. I got quotes from florists for upwards of $4,000 for the entire wedding, centerpiece, boutonnieres, bouquets, everything, and I just didn't want to spend that much money on something that would just last like half a day, you know? So DIY it was, and we had so much fun creatively and just bonding time with all of the bridesmaids and everyone putting the flower arrangements together. Anyways, I hope you guys liked this video. If you want to see more DIY tutorials, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up and please don't forget to subscribe below. If you guys are having your own wedding or in a wedding in your family, I want to know what you guys are doing for your DIY. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!